Hey everyone, it's Jang here with my first LEGO City update of 2017. Let's get right into it, starting over there. I've installed a couple of the 2017 structures with the bank and this cafe build, and the cafe went in place of my small organic grocery store, which has since been moved out that way. So it now lives awkwardly next to Quickie Mart temporarily, but fortunately at least the Quickie Mart no longer has dinosaurs encroaching upon it because other stuff has changed over in this corner. The Jurassic World stuff has been moved out, and in its place I have an old dinosaur exhibit idea, Dinosaurs at the Park. It's an animatronic exhibit that I originally had in my old city years ago. It was the very first kind of display, temporary display really, for the sake of the minifigures. So these are all just animatronic dinosaurs that folks can come in and visit and take a look at. Ticket booth right there, small vendor for some toys, some plushes and such. And, you know, folks can just come in and get up close to some fake dinosaurs. The Jurassic World sets that I had here previously went on both sides of the train tracks, so with all of those gone, on the opposite side of the tracks that really aren't accessible, I've just kind of fleshed out more temporary foliage and some rock formations. They're very, very temporary, set up very quickly just to start the kind of the suggestion of what goes in between the areas that can be built upon. So inside of these holes in the tables where you can see through, where I actually have to go to be able to get in closer there. It's all supposed to be kind of undeveloped areas. So there's kind of some matching stuff on the other side, and I've just brought that over to here. But since I'm talking about the other side right there, let me go ahead and take you over there to some small changes on that side. The rock formations down here have been expanded just a little bit, but they're pretty temporary and they really don't look very good. Major thing that I've done here is add in these large trees, the biggest trees that I've made so far. And I'll be keeping those trees, but I might not keep them exactly where they are. As a matter of fact, I probably won't keep them exactly where they are. They're in place right now, mostly just to help camouflage this from any kind of distance, just so that you don't see inside of structures quite so easily that are open around the back. Because I added some more 2017 structures over here, I think that the colors of that friend's house look much nicer than I expected. It's just out of scale, unfortunately, with everything being a little bit on the tall side, but it's temporary. Also, the little creator house there is temporary. It's kind of small, but it's just better to me to have something here that looks nice, and I don't care what anybody else thinks about what it looks like. It looks nice to me, and looks a lot nicer than having absolutely nothing there. It's better to have some nice builds than to just have completely empty, unused space. And then another version of the creator, you know, small building, a small house is over here. Again, just taking up some space. And I think that one looks nice. Maybe a little bit lonely over there, but that's okay. And then there's some more stuff that has been done over on this side. Check that out. That's right. I added in another tree, small little palm tree right here on this side. And then also covered up all the water space. Well, almost all the water space. I actually ran out of trans blue pieces again. I underestimated exactly how many I needed to go under the docks and everything. So I've already made another BrickLink order to fill some of that in, but let me actually move you up a little closer so you can see a nice effect with these. Maybe it doesn't show up on camera quite as well as it does in person, but there's some shimmer to the surface of the water, and that's because I did not orient all of the 1x2 plate pieces in the same ways. I have a little bit of patterning in there, nothing that repeats too consistently. I kind of break it up along the way, but it just has a nice look to it that I really like. And yes, I will add little bits of simulated waves and ripples and things over time, but you know, that'll come as kind of layers are added. But for now, this is just looking so much better than having it just plain with just the original base plate blue color that was there before. Much, much happier with this. Like I said, still need to fill in a little bit more. I don't even have everything underneath the static portion, the fully stationary portion of the bridge filled in, but just around the edges. And then I've also got the shoreline kind of filled in a little bit better over by the beach, and that also looks much nicer. So there's the sand, there's the wet sand, and then you see just a little bit of the shore kind of going underneath the water, and then it gets a little bit darker. Very happy with that. And again, I will add some ripples. I won't go crazy with waves. There's no reason to go crazy with waves over here. This is a covered, protected area, so it's not going to have a lot of wind, not going to have a lot of waves on it. But yeah, that's a nice little bit of change here. Beyond that, off in the background, I covered up part of the fireplace. It turns out I had some paper on a roll that would fit just perfectly, or pretty close to perfectly, against the wall with its color. So that's temporary, but at least it takes some of the appearance of the fireplace away. I've explained before that I'm not going to tear that fireplace out of the house at a cost of many thousands of dollars while also devaluing the house further thousands of dollars. I'm not going to do that just to you know, make things look a little bit cleaner in here. But I will eventually pursue a slightly more permanent, more lasting cover to go over that. But I think that pretty much takes care of the changes. There are probably a bunch of little things that I've missed. I'm always doing little things here and there, but obviously you've seen me doing lots and lots and lots and lots of reviews, and I still have many more to do. And all of that work that I have done is the reason that I haven't done other work. I've been staying very busy, but still continuing to put a little bit of effort into the city whenever I get a chance, or to take an extra break, because I enjoy this maybe a little bit more than the review stuff, but you know, gotta get out the content that folks are asking for. But that's it for this update for, you know, the very first time in 2017. A lot more to come, a lot more work to be done. So thank you for watching. Thank you for your patience. I'll talk to you again soon.